Hey, what's going on, everyone? A couple years ago, I bought a laser printer that was colored on slick deals. I think I only paid like 70 or 80 bucks for it. And it was one of those Ricoh C250DNs, I believe, or SPC250s. I forgot what the exact model number was. But anyway, I've been using it for a couple years and the toner finally ran out recently. Before the toner ran out, the chips on them actually quit counting. They have a chip on them that keep track of how many pages and how much you print, and then they basically disable it so you can't print afterwards. So anyway, so I reset a couple months back and I started using it and I ran out of toner. So finally I got around to actually buying toner off of Amazon. And today I'm gonna go over how to take it apart and fill it up and put it back together. So as you can see here, these are the three toners I ordered off of Amazon. I think I paid 40 bucks for them. So you got the red, the blue, or actually magenta, blue, yellow, and then black, which I think is not those. I mean, those are the close enough colors. They're like cyan, magenta, and whatever yellow is, and I think it's just yellow. But anyway, and this is the black cartridge. So I'll go over the black cartridge today and how to take it apart. It's the same for all four of them. Here's the chip on the side right there that keeps track of the count on the pages for the toner. You could usually pay like $12, $13 extra for the ones that come with the chip, and then what you do is you cut the old chip off and then you stick the new chip on and then tape it back on. I actually bought the little, it was a $10 programmable board that I was able to load the program onto, and then I made a little 4-pin connector that I actually just touch those 4 pins right here, and then I write to it from a computer to reset it. So I'll go over that once I'm done with refilling this toner. First thing you want to do is just wrap your cartridge with a piece of paper towel so you could protect the drum on here. You just wrap it with a piece of paper towel and then use some rubber bands, or in my case, just the girl's hair ties, and put it over. Just good enough to cover the drum. Two screws on this, so you got two sides here. So you want to take the sides off without the chip on it. You're just using the hand. It's good. Pull it right off. Be careful with all the toner. So actually I shouldn't have dumped that. Anyway, just have a vacuum nearby. Once you clean up the big old mess like I did, you can go ahead and start filling it up. So first thing you gotta do is pop the cap off of here. So easiest way is just use a plier. Kind of work it out. Deformed it, and then once the hole's open, then you can start filling it up. For the black, I got this one. What I would recommend, this thing comes with a tiny nozzle. Just cut the nozzle all the way at the bottom. That way that you open the hole bigger, and then so that way it makes it easier once you get to the bottom of the toner. The key there is just let it flow out of the bottle lightly. Don't push it too hard. On the other end, it popped out of the hole, so I had to realign the hole. Anyway. Gotta make sure that the pins here are aligned. Line up everything on this side. should pop in pretty easily. Let's do that. The screws, screw them back on. Now that I got all the toner filled up for all these cartridges, I gotta reset the chips on them. So what I end up using is the Arduino Uno, and the version I have is just the generic $10 one I found on Amazon. I think it's made by Allegro, but it's got the same chips and the same programming capability as the original Arduinos. The original one is about $20-$22, and this is about half the price, and it does the same thing. In order for me to set the chip, I had to create this little pen thing that touches the four pins on the toner cartridge. As you can see, I just used some old pins from one of my electronic kits, and then I butt connected them to a piece of wire into there, and then just to make the contacts. On the actual board itself, you've got several different pinouts on here, so I've got them color-coded, like red is for 5 volts, black is for ground, and then I've got the A4 and A5 line are the data lines. The one's a clock and one's a data line. So I got this off of another YouTuber and some guys online that have done this already. So, you know, if you want to see that video from, I think it's DIY Tinker or one of those guys, he has a pretty good video about it, but that's all I did, and actually used his code, used his program that he had on his YouTube, and he actually has all the code. All you have to do is go in here and change right up here. He's got all the comments for you for 83 for black, 82 for cyan, 81 for magenta, and 80 for yellow. So all you do is change the address number right here, load it through the Arduino, get it, make sure you could actually run it. I think on his instructions, he just has me, he lets it run and then he hits the reset button once he has the pins touching the toner cartridge. So that's all you really need to do. And it's pretty quick. I think it has another window that shows you the readout, the read in and read out. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to do that now and see how it works. So after I programmed everything, just drop the reinstall your cartridges, everything in there. Close the lid. Log into the web page. Check, make sure all the toners are all reset on the pages. So I logged into the printer. It looks like all the settings are all reset back to zero. All the cartridges show that they're full. Everything looks like it's good, so I'm gonna print a test page and make sure everything's working properly. Looks like that baby is printed out nice and perfect. Laser print. Alright, well, thanks for watching, guys. If you like my video, please like, share, and subscribe, and just look out for my videos on cars and other tech stuff around the house. Thanks for watching.